You want to get married now. You want to celebrate now. So you're planning a virtual wedding. But just because it's virtual doesn't mean it shouldn't be special. It should be. Today, we're continuing our virtual wedding series with another way to make your virtual wedding special by doing the abnormal. Hi there, I'm Jamie Chang, your destination wedding planning guru and designer of joy at Mango Meets Events and the creator of Passport to Joy, the step-by-step online wedding planning course for couples. And I share real and honest and useful wedding planning tips, tricks, and advice you can use to help make planning your wedding more joyful and easy. Because you want to create a wedding you love, and we want that too. And let's be honest, wedding planning isn't always very easy. In fact, it can be downright painful, especially now. So, bringing the joy back to wedding planning. Are you ready? Let's do this. Now, today we are continuing our virtual wedding series and talking about how to make this very different kind of wedding, this virtual wedding, special. Because it should be special. It should feel special even if it's virtual. But first, before we begin, I want to make sure you hit subscribe so that you can get all of the videos in this series and all the ones in the future ones too. And if you haven't checked out our last two videos, make sure you do so. The first, we talked about your ceremony, and in the second, we talked about your guests. And today, we're going to be talking about another way to make your virtual wedding special by doing the abnormal. Now, you might have a this kind of face right now, or a what is Jamie talking about kind of face right now? And let me explain, because it's not a bad thing. Now, we're all living in sort of a new normal, right? Maybe you're at home a lot and it's one where your only outside contact is a chance to walk the dog or go to the grocery store, or one where, you live on video calls all day because that's how you connect. Or perhaps if you're on the front lines in some way or another, your new normal is about wearing a mask 24/7. So, to make your virtual wedding special, you want to do the abnormal. What does that mean, right, Jamie? What does that mean? It means making it different from your current everyday life. Now, this is a special day, right? It's a special day. It's your wedding day, even though it's a virtual wedding. And so, you want to treat this day like your wedding day. And if you think about it, really, your wedding day is full of lots of sort of abnormal, non-everyday things, right? So just by sort of doing the abnormal, finding ways to do that will help make that day special and will make that celebration feel special. So let's go through some examples because you might be thinking, I still don't know what that means. Let me go through some examples and it'll help your brain a little bit and get your brain kind of thinking about what that could mean for you. So, first, dress up. So, if you've been living in sweatpants, which no judgments, I have too, if you've been living in sweatpants or athleisure or something of that nature for the last few months, this is a chance to get dressed, like for real dressed. And if you have your wedding attire, obviously wear it because this is your wedding day. But if you don't, think about what you own and pick out perhaps a favorite outfit, something that you love, that you feel good in, and that's nice and maybe considered special occasion for you. Now, I want to make sure I say that there's, no judgments here. So you don't have to wear white. You don't have to wear evening attire if that's not your thing. You just have to pick something that, you feel good in because when you feel good, you look good. And when you look good, you feel good. And they go hand in hand, and you want something that you like on you and something that makes you feel good. Because this is, right, a day to feel good. That's what this is all about. Now, another option is to take this opportunity to maybe buy yourself something. It could be from maybe a favorite retailer or a designer or a boutique store. And side note, obviously many businesses are suffering right now, so it's also a chance to sort of help out a small business potentially that you love. Pick out something that you think is special, whether that's, wedding day-y or not. It could just be something, some dress or outfit or shirt or tie or whatever that you just are really into. And go for it. Now, another idea besides dressing up is to do your hair and makeup. And obviously, this lends itself more to the women, to the ladies. But if you're anything like me, right, this is definitely not something you do every day, especially now, right, when you're just kind of at home all the time. But even if it is, even if hair and makeup is a daily thing for you know, this is a chance to sort of take it up a notch. So don't do your kind of normal everyday look. Maybe put your hair up, you know, or curl it, or do that smoky eye, or try something new. Try something that maybe you've always wanted to try. Make your look special because, you know, like your outfit, when you look good, you feel good, and when you feel good, you look good, and it all just kind of works together. And it makes this occasion, this celebration, this day special. Okay, now outside of the way you look, which is just sort of one idea here, I want to talk about what actually takes place on this virtual wedding day, because those elements can help make it special too. So we talked about this a little bit in our last video, but why not share a moment with, say, your mom or your dad or your grandma or your best friend or your wedding party in a way that you would on your wedding day, because this is once again still your wedding day. You know, maybe that's a phone call. Maybe that's a video call. Maybe it's a sleepover the night before. Maybe it's a virtual brunch with your sisters. Maybe it's a virtual drink with your close group of friends. Or it's, you know, getting ready maybe virtually with your mom. Now, the great thing about a virtual wedding, which we've said a few times here, is that you can do what you want. You know, this is a non-traditional wedding. It just is. And it gives you that opportunity and that chance to kind of do what you really want to do. So let's say the whole, you know, wedding party, bachelor, bachelorette thing was kind of never your scene, or the whole getting ready thing was never something you wanted, or let's say who you really wanted to hang out with before your wedding was your grandpa. Like, you can do that and not feel bad. It's really a chance to kind of do what you really want, and that's kind of great, isn't it? So find a way to maybe celebrate with the people that you love in a way that makes sense for you and for them and for who you are and the way you want to celebrate. And then let's not forget the biggest, most important person in the room, your partner. Now, you likely live with them and you're likely seeing them a lot, 24/7, right? Which may not be the usual for you. You are cooking together, you're maybe working together, you're watching movies together, you're working out together even. And you want to make your virtual wedding special by spending some time together in a different way. So maybe that's getting ready separately in different rooms and then, you know, staging your own first look with some fun photos. It doesn't have to be cheesy. It doesn't have to be, you know, over the top or feel weird or fake or whatever. Just do it in a fun way for you. Or maybe it's, you know, writing a little love note to them that you give to them ahead of time, or buying a small gift and hiding it and doing a little scavenger hunt for each other on the morning of your wedding. Or maybe it's, you know, celebrating with them in a romantic way. And this is maybe after you've celebrated with your friends and your family, is spending some time romantically together. That could be, you know, just as simple as lighting some candles and having an amazing meal, something out of the ordinary that maybe you've always wanted. Or putting on some music and cuddling up and talking about the favorite moments of the day. And while a normal wedding day is pretty tiring, you know, you can ask sort of any couple who's been married, it's a long day. Why not take advantage of this sort of lighter version and, you know, consummate the marriage? You know, get a little lovin'. Not a bad idea. Not a bad idea to start a marriage or a way to start a marriage. Now, these are just a few different ways or different ideas to get kind of your brain thinking to help you make your virtual wedding day special. There are lots more ideas. And I think it's really important that you customize this for you and what makes sense for you and what feels right for you and just, you know, make sense for you, your partner, and your wedding day. And if you think about it from the aspect of a normal wedding day and doing sort of the abnormal from what is your everyday life now, you know, you can find ways that make that day special, that make that experience special. And that's what you should really be thinking through. And we're going to be talking about more ways to make your virtual wedding special in the continuation of this series. So make sure you hit subscribe so you can get all the new ones. All right. Now, here's my question for you today. What's one abnormal thing that you're planning on doing on your wedding day? Let me know in a comment below. And if you enjoyed today's video, please like it. Give us some thumbs up. We love that. You can check out our other videos for even more tips. And please hit subscribe so you can get all the new ones and all the new ones in this series. And of course, if you want help through the entire wedding planning process, please check out my online course, Passport to Joy. You can find all the links below. Because you deserve to enjoy your engagement, no matter what your budget is or in the middle of a pandemic. Thanks so much for being here, and I'll see you next time. Bye.